Yeah, let's talk about Maogola West,
Yes.
where the race was majorly between Anifa Kawoya and Joseph Sekavito.
Yes.
How did it go that side?
Well, it was equally tense and very tough. If you look at the results, Sekavito pulled 45.2%, then Anifa Kawoya won with 54.8%. But that is the in Anifa, rather Sekavito's stronghold area. You know, when they split, Maogola South and Maogola was both curved. They expected that Sekavito would remain in Maogola South and Anifa shift to Maogola West. But unfortunately, they chose to compete in one constituency and leave the other. And according to the senior people in that area, this would give an upper hand to Sekavito, because this is where he's born, this is where his dad, who is the late Mumina son of the prince, I think he had a better environment, winning environment. But Anifa Kawoya came out smarter.
How did she work it out? Because no one expected Anifa Kawoya to edge out, Kavito, who has been on ground, the incumbent. And, one would say Anifa Kawoya was a foreigner, she has been at the woman MP in the Ovale district, and then she crossed to Maogola West.
We were all surprised.
Earlier,
there was a complaint that there are voters, French voters, coming from the neighboring areas of Goengo district, those conferences surrounding that Maogola West. And Anifa was happy, surprisingly, that they go by the voters' register. But at one point, even the voters' registers were disregarded. Those earlier decisions that we shall follow the voters' registers, the village vetting committees will decide on those who don't feature there. At one point, those things didn't work out.
So you think it was really, she did a great job on the ground for her to have, gone through?
As you know, Anifa Kawoya, she's a very aggressive woman.
Mm-hmm.
It's no joke.